Hi, and welcome to this Perspectively episode about history-relevant riots and protests that have changed the world. First though, a distinction must be made between both terms. A riot is usually depicted as a congregation of people that violently revolt to show their discontent over a certain matter. A protest, on the other hand, is often defined as a peaceful demonstration. However, both having quite a different meaning, media and people in general tend to mix both terms so they can give an occurrence a desired connotation, riot being usually negative and protests being more positive. Since all roads lead to Rome, this is where we'll start.
Beware the Ides of March.
Beware the Ides of March indeed. On the Ides of March, that is March the 15th of the year 44 BCE, Julius Caesar's dictatorship suddenly finished when he was assassinated by a group of men. 5 days later, and during his cremation ceremony, the people who assisted, moved by Mark Antony's words, or otherwise Caesar's good old friend, started rioting. This did not change the already tense political disputes, but it set the starting point of a series of civil wars that marked the end of the Roman Republic and the beginning of the Roman Empire. About 1500 years later, in the 16th century, Europe was going through a new sort of protest. Started by Martin Luther, the Protestant Reformation was born as a peaceful way to detach from the unfairness of the Catholic Church. Of course, the Catholic Church was not happy about this, nor were their reliable members, who fiercely stood up against the Reformation and in several occasions rioted against their once beloved neighbors. The European Wars of Religion lasted a whopping 190 years, and the more notable wars were the French Wars of Religion with estimated 2 to 4 million deaths, including dark chapters like the St. Bartholomew's Day Massacre, in which thousands were killed after King Charles IX decided it was time to kill some non-Catholic Protestants. The following so-called 30 Years' War, which was part of the religious wars in neighboring Germany, would kill about 20% of their population, which is proportionally higher than the Second World War. Who said again that religion saves lives? The year is now 1776, and Boston, a city that was once a conservative's paradise, is about to riot its way into independence. A series of oppressive events led to the famous Boston Massacre and the Boston Tea Party, both essential for the Revolutionary Wars to take place and give Americans their independence. Soon after, the French had their own issues to deal with, and with the Enlightening already being a thing in 1789, pretty much 98% of the people of France decided they had enough of their abusive king, clergy, and nobility. People protested, but the Estates General, the closest thing to a parliament in many, many years, were yet another way for the royalty to get what they wanted. People rebelled and rioted for days. When the few resting members of the French Guard were about to attack their own people on July the 14th, the people of Paris stole the weapons from the Hôtel des Invalides and stormed the Bastille, where they got enough powder for their newly won weapons. The French Revolution has finally started, and with it, a whole bunch of countries around the world followed with their own demands to their governments. This forced a tremendous change in society, politics, and in the economy. The possibly best example of a peaceful rebellion was Mahatma Gandhi's Salt March in 1930. 23 days of walking with thousands of people only to reach the sea and make salt. Colonialism was indeed so brutal that making or selling salt in British-dominated India was illegal. Eventually, the so-called Satyagraha, or Truth Force, that is Gandhi's non-violent protests, led India to become an independent nation. Thanks to Gandhi, Indians can call themselves citizens of the world's largest democracy. In 1966, San Francisco was starting to bloom. Unfortunately, not everyone was welcome. Compton's cafeteria became the only place where trans people and cross-dressers could meet up. Police raids were common. The trans community eventually had enough of the cafeteria's anti-trans policy and of policemen arresting them and stealing their money. On an unknown night on August, the trans community stood against police on what would become the first of many riots including Stonewall a couple of years later, that would open a debate on civil rights all around the world. So the Africa's apartheid system ended 26 years ago, yet the fight for equal treatment of all ethnicities was not easy. In 1976, the South African government was forcing black students to study in Afrikaans, a language that is widely spoken by white or mixed people. The students were not happy and started a march that would end up with the lives of many young people. An official estimate put the number of black students killed by police at about 500. This moment will stay in history as one of the many decisive moments in the long process of peaceful fights against apartheid. Not many years before this, Martin Luther King's I Have a Dream speech during the Washington March led to JFK's civil rights legislations. The end of the 1980s marked the beginning of the end of the Cold War. Protests and riots played a major role, some being more successful than others. Take the Berlin Wall, for example. In 1987, David Bowie's concert for East Berliners from the other side of the wall unleashed a series of demonstrations that some years later led to the fall of the wall. In China, the Tiananmen Square protests finished with a massacre that cost many lives and stayed in the collective memory as a symbolic movement against oppression. Some would say that the ongoing Hong Kong protests are directly linked to this chapter in Chinese history. The 21st century has witnessed major uprisings in the world. The Arab Spring, for example, that has changed North Africa and most of the Middle East in unprecedented ways. Movements for a fair distribution of wealth in South America. Black Lives Matter and Fridays for Future are only a few that don't have an ultimate outcome just yet. Time will tell. One thing is certain. Demonstrations, riots, protests, and uprisings have the strength to change the world. This list only depicts a few of history-changing events. Feel free to comment below what other relevant moments should have been added to the list. If you like this video and would like to support me in making more of them, please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to like the video.